Hey guys, how's it going? This is Taras again from Dub Club. So today, what I'm gonna be doing is installing a short shifter into the Mark IV Jetta. There it is. Getting down to the roots, some Mark IV VWs on the channel. Now this short shifter I got off of eBay. It's sold by Wolfsburg Tuning, I guess. Not too sure, don't know how well it's gonna do, but I just hate the amount of travel that the shift knob has in that thing to get from gear to gear. So I figured, why not? It was like 65 bucks or something. So I'll throw it in, see how it goes, see how I like it. Hopefully it's gonna last and not just crap out, you know, within a couple of months or so, or weeks. So yeah, here it is, just in this box. Got some paperwork. I'm assuming there's a receipt in here somewhere. Yep. So here it is, wolfsburgtuning.com. $73 was the total. Open this bad boy up. There's the little Wolfsburg tuning card. All right, so here it is. Now it looks pretty cool, actually. I kind of like the design, and hopefully it functions as well as it looks. The welds don't look too bad, and I guess if it ever needs welded up, I do have a TIG welder now, so you can even TIG weld it. But it comes with all these little parts. I'm not sure how many of these I'm actually going to use. I might just try to reuse the factory VW parts as much as I can, just because I feel like they'll be a little better quality than these. But yeah, I like the shift knob. It looks pretty sweet. It's nice and heavy, so hopefully that will fix my huge throw issue. So alright, so I'm gonna go ahead and get started. The first thing I'm gonna have to do is obviously pull the center console out, which is just a couple of bolts in this thing, a couple of screws, nothing crazy. I'm just gonna go ahead and time-lapse through that. If you guys want to know how to actually do it, I guess you can leave some comments, and I'll actually go into detail about it. But I'm assuming that if you're going to be throwing on your own short shifter, you're going to be able to remove this center console. So let's do this. And obviously, if you have any questions, I can help you out. So just leave me a comment and I'll answer it as soon as I can. Alright guys, so I just removed the center console. Here it is, right there. So now I got access to this shift knob mechanism. So I'm gonna go ahead and start taking it apart. Now before I start just yanking stuff out of there, I'm gonna look at the new one and see what exactly needs to come out so I don't take something off that doesn't need to come off. So just gonna take the new one into the car and start yanking stuff out. Judging just based off of this thing here, it looks like this clip needs to come out. That's right over here. So just one of the standard VW shifter linkage clips. You just gotta pull up on this tab and then it slides up. Now I'm gonna try to just wiggle this thing out of here. I really don't wanna have to put this thing up on the lift and take this whole assembly off. So I'm gonna unscrew these two and hopefully I can get the ball out and then just kind of slide it out that way out of this joint right here. I guess we'll see how that goes. All right, so unfortunately, it looks like I am gonna have to put it on the lift and drop this whole mechanism out. Good thing is, I don't think it should be too bad. Bad thing is, I think the exhaust is right under there, so might have to do something with the exhaust to kind of get it out of the way for this to drop out. At least drop down enough to where I could get to this, because right now I'm stuck. So before I go ahead and raise this thing up all the way, I'm gonna unscrew this mechanism, which is these two nuts right here. I think there's probably at least two more on the bottom in the car, but this is all I see for this side. If you guys have a factory exhaust, this part is really gonna suck a lot. So what you gotta do is remove the exhaust, which if it's factory, I think you might have to drop the downpipe. And then you gotta remove this little heat shield around here. And then that you should be able to drop that shifter mechanism after that. For me, I am kind of lucky. This car does have a 2.5-inch Kerma TDI, I believe. I think it's a straight pipe, but I mean, there it looks like there's a resonator or something in here. Maybe it's a cat, I don't know. But so luckily for me, I can unscrew these two nuts around here and unscrew this clamp right here and just drop this midsection down from here to here. And that should give me enough room to pull that shifter mechanism. All right, so a little more disassembly than I thought is gonna be required. I'm gonna have to pull this heat shield off around here. And as well as you've seen me pull the exhaust off, as well as this bracket, which I did snap a couple of the studs, just two. So I should be all right. It's gonna hold. But now I'm gonna take off this bracket right here, and then it should be pretty easy to get to the shifter. So here are the rear two bolts on the shifter linkage. After I get those out, should be ready to roll. All right, so this is getting a little more involved than I thought it would. So it looks like I gotta unbend these tabs right here and pull the bottom off and then pull this linkage out. And then hopefully I'll be able to get to this shifter rod thing. So let's do this then, I guess. We're already this far in, ain't going back out now. Okay, got the shifter off. Way more than I wanted to do today. But we're gonna get this thing, we're gonna get it. Just had to pull this thing off before I could actually get enough clearance to get this out. So let's throw a torn in. Put some new grease on this bad boy. Stick this old thing in here. God dang, guys, this looks freaking sweet. Super pumped for this. And I'm super excited because this is kind of like how my SDI was, where instead of pushing the shift knob down, you gotta pull this ring up to get it into reverse. So that's pretty cool. The only thing I'm worried about breaking on this thing, this being an eBay part, is just this seal, this bushing right here. I'm afraid it might pop out, but I guess we'll cross that bridge whenever we get there. So, gotta throw this back in and give it a try. Like that. All right, so first thing we're gonna test is gonna be side to side, whether it affected. So let's just put it at 4 inches here in the middle. So that goes about 2.5, 5.5. So that's like a 3-inch throw right there, side to side. Now front to back. Let's see, put it at 4. It's about 2. Wait, moved it down. About 2.6. So that's like a, 4-inch?
Yeah.
All right, so we got 3 inches side to side and 4 inches front to back. Now let's go measure a factory one. So, all right, so I'm gonna go ahead and guess that it's like 16 inches front to back and like 12 inches side to side. All right, put it at,
got fuel pump.
Put it at 4. That's about a little less, about 1.25. Well, that is actually a big difference.
Mm-hmm.
About 7 or 6.75. So that's what, like, so it's like 1.5 inches yeah. shorter. Front to back, I was surprised because I didn't think it was gonna actually affect it that much. Front to back. All right, now side to side. This is what it is, shorter?
So,
it's like the same.
I think my shifter is weird. I don't think it, I don't know if it does back to, or front to back. Okay. Or side to side, I don't know if it affects it.
All right, so side to side, we got from 4 to 5.5 and then 4 to 1.5. So that's 4 inches, 3 inches, 3 inches. Man. Oh, I just got my tape measure.
Oof.
My expensive tape measure. All right. So it's 1.5 and 2.5. Yeah, so that's 4 inches.
Yeah.
So side to side didn't change, but front to back definitely got a lot shorter. If you're wanting to lose 2 inches, go ahead and install a short throw. All right, guys, see you. Come here, come hold this camera real quick. I gotta hold the tape measure, bruh.